Meteorologist Ashley Ruiz here, and we have flooding around the area, so that is why we are coming to you right now on NBC Local 33 and Fox 44. So we'll get right to it, checking out the Doppler radar this morning. We have an aerial flood advisory that's going to continue for another hour or so. That includes the Baton Rouge Metro. That's this green color that you see on your screen. That includes West Baton Rouge Parish, Northern Assumption Parish, Northwestern Ascension Parish, Southwestern East Baton Rouge Parish, Southeastern Iberville Parish, West Central Livingston, and as I mentioned, West Baton Rouge Parish. Ongoing flooding in the low-lying areas, poor drainage areas around the city, this will be the case. We're already seeing some reports of flooding. In fact, 110 right now is a mess. We have several reports from DOTD. The exit ramp from 110 North to North Street, that's exit 1D, is now open. However, 110 South is closed past Chippewa Street due to high water, and then congestion has reached Chippewa Street. So you need to use an alternate route, and this is going to be an issue at least for a little while. So what you're seeing on your screen right now, the two top boxes, that's 110 at Governor's Mansion, and then on the other box, which I'll zoom in for you, this is 110 at 22nd Street. You can see that there's high water, and we already have a vehicle stalled out, so people are trying to get around this on the shoulder. So again, heavy rain around the area. We're going to continue to follow this. Not just that, we still have a flash flood warning in effect, which I'll zoom in and kind of show you. That's for Ascension Parish. This is going to continue at least until noontime. The good news is the heavy rain is starting to let up for these areas. This is for Sorrento and parts of Gonzales, although not all of Gonzales is under this flash flood warning. As you see, the red color, the maroon color, that is a flash flood warning. We're still seeing reports of flooding all the way north of Gonzales near Airline, and then LA 44 as well. So if you are just about to go out, maybe run some errands, go out for lunch, I would hold off for at least a little while longer while some of these storms start to move to the east. They're currently moving to the east around 10 miles per hour, so yes, it is slow, slowly pushing to the east, but at least it's moving. Not too long ago, in fact, we had some training. You kind of see how it was back building a good bit, kind of training along I-10 and just dumping relentless rain. So that is why we had that flash flood warning as well as that aerial flood advisory. As for rainfall rates, this is just radar indicated where some of the heaviest of rain is currently falling. Perhaps over 3 inches per hour. Thankfully, again, it is moving to the east, so we'll get a few inches of rainfall in a short amount of time, which again could lead to some flash flooding issues, but at least it is starting to move to the east. And some of the rainfall totals, this is again radar estimated. And this is actually not really updating some of the new information. It takes a little while for it to get in. Once the rain kind of lets up a little bit, we'll have better understanding of how much rain we potentially have seen, but it's estimating over 3 to 6 inches just within the last, I know it says the last 12 hours, but this is just within the last 2 hours or so. And again, we're not done with the rain just yet. So we're going to continue to follow this. Some flood advice for you guys only in tips. 6 inches of moving water can knock you down. 1 foot of water will float vehicles, and 2 feet of rushing water can carry most vehicles, including SUVs. That's why we are seeing some of these vehicles stalling out in some of these low-lying areas that are prone to flooding. Again, thankfully, the heavy rain is starting to let up a little bit, mainly west of the Mississippi River. So we're still not out of the clear. We're still going to be dealing with some heavy rain in the coming hours, and not just today. maybe even tomorrow we'll see some passing showers and thunderstorms that may lead to some flash flooding issues. That is why the National Weather Service has gone ahead and issued this flash flood watch. This is going to continue through Tuesday evening. So we can see an additional 3 to 6 inches of rainfall. Some spots could easily see over that, but those will be isolated spots. If you get caught under one of these training thunderstorms or just really slow moving thunderstorms, you can double or triple these amounts. We know this happens here in South Louisiana. We get some pretty intense thunderstorms. So again, we have that flash flood warning. You may even get alerts on your screen with any flash flood warnings we have. They will come across on your screen, so you'll get the information there. But now is the time, if you haven't already, download our free BR Proud app. I can't stress this enough how great of a tool it is, and I'm not just saying that. It really is a great tool to have. As soon as a weather alert is issued or even breaking news, anything like that, it's pushed to your phone. It uses GPS. Location. So if you're under your neighborhood's under a flash flood warning, you will get that notification instantaneously. And you can zoom in and look at the radar for yourself to see what what is over your house, to see if you're getting the heavy rain. And then you can also zoom into your street level and then track these thunderstorms as well. So also, if you have any reports, please send them our way safely, of course. If you have any photos, you can find us on Facebook. Just search BR Proud on Facebook. You can message us, post it on there, or you can email the newsroom. Send a photo report and then where you're sending it from to news@brproud.com, or you can reach out to me directly at aruez@brproud.com. I can relay the information to the National Weather Service as well. So you guys are our eyes out there. We also depend on you, but please do so very, very safely. Again, download the free BR Proud app, and if we have any other information, we'll be sure to bring it to you. Y'all stay safe, stay weather aware.